I know, you just want to start learning right now. But before we begin, it's very important to set the right expectations. I'm going to tell you exactly just how difficult should you expect the CompTIA CySA Plus exam to be. Trust me, you're going to need this. Hi, I'm Andrew, this is Certified Breakfast, and I'm about to tell you exactly how hard this exam is going to kick your butt. So I'm going to give you 10 pieces of advice, which I strongly believe that you should know before the exam. Most certifications tell you that you need this much experience to ride in their exam roller coaster. And while the CySA Plus also does this here, even though it's not a mandatory requirement, I would so much want to tell you that you don't need this much experience. And I am going to tell you that you do not need that on-the-job experience. It's nice to have, it will make your life easier on exam day, but don't give up just because you don't have that job experience. You can learn everything you need to know right now. The CySA Plus exam expects you to have two major skills. The first one is about understanding basic security principles that apply in computer networks. And the second one is about you being able to understand and interpret the outputs and commands from some of those specific security tools. Which means great news for you, right? Exam study can be done in the comfort of your pajamas, and also becoming familiar with these tools can also be done in couch potato mode from the comfort of your home, as we'll see on number 3. Security without tools is just a bunch of policies, and we already have our dear CISSP exam for that. So the CySA Plus exam wants you to know how to use certain tools and how to read some text outputs or to understand some graphical user interface. It's not so difficult as it sounds. Your laptop is more than enough for these tools. Most of them are free anyway and come packed in the Kali Linux distribution. And you certainly don't need to buy any additional hardware for your labs. And if you're a bit lazy, you can even get away with just watching these tools in action, like in our next videos. And even though the exam will test just how comfortable you are around security devices, such as firewalls, IPSs, you don't need to have those in your home or at work. Right, obviously, which brings us to security vendors. CompTIA exams pride themselves for being vendor neutral or vendor agnostic, so they don't focus on a specific vendor out there. Well, the problem is the real world is vendor specific, obviously. So getting some experience from real firewalls, antivirus solutions, I don't know, spam filters, means that you get vendor specific experience. Well, the good news is that CISA exam tries to stay away from specific solutions. So as long as you can read any type of firewall rule or any type of syslog entry, you'll be fine. It doesn't matter if you've only seen Cisco or Checkpoint or Dell before. Even if you haven't seen any, just keep watching. And also number 5. I've been through more than 30 certification exams, and I've never ever found one single source of information that helps you get that 100% in the exam. I love the trainings from sites like LinkedIn or Pluralsight. But unfortunately, those videos barely scratch the surface of what you need to know to pass the CISA Plus exam. So if you learn from other CISA trainings out there, I beg you, don't make the mistake of assuming that it's going to be enough. That kind of overconfidence is a recipe for disaster on the exam day, so I strongly suggest that you do your own research. Google is your friend. Exploit it. You know, not in a bad way. One thing I don't like is ambiguous and non-technical questions in a technical exam. Questions that ask you about the best solution without telling you if it should be the most secure one, the cheapest one, the most convenient one for the users. Questions that ask you about trends and opinions that don't give you enough context. From my perspective, a technical question should be like a computer. Give me the right input, the question, and I will give you the right and the only right answer. After 3 CompTIA certifications so far, I must say that they do have this habit of pushing these weird, ambiguous questions in their exams very often, worse than other vendors out there. And yes, Cisco, I'm looking at you. You're pushing marketing in your exams, and I don't know which is worse. Don't worry, you will begin to understand the mindset of the test makers. We'll make some dedicated videos on practice tests to help you understand how CompTIA thinks. And then it hits you with something like number 7. Out-of-date questions are about technologies that are rarely used nowadays, but for some reason someone forgot them in the exam pool. Things like mitigating some attack which hasn't been an issue since, I don't know, 10 years ago, or assuming that antivirus software hasn't evolved in the past 20 years. Talking about BlackBerry phones in the enterprise, stuff like that. Make sure you subscribe as we will cover these as well, at least in one special video, which brings us to another surprise in the exam, number 8. If you're facing the CySA Plus exam after going through the Network Plus and Security Plus exams, like I did, you're in for a bit of a surprise, which kicks in about after the first 15 minutes of the exam. It's a bit more difficult. I must admit, I kind of breezed through the Network Plus and the Security Plus exams. They had a lot of weird questions, but they were not as difficult as the CISA Plus exam, which really goes in depth on some topics and expects you to pay a lot of attention to details. Many questions will punish you for not paying enough attention to the context or for reading an output in a hurry. Don't make that mistake. Don't rush. And I'm not saying it's a bad thing, because in real life as well, the devil is in the details, right? Just pay attention and you should be fine. I've studied for the CISSP, Security Plus, CISA Plus, Certified Ethical Hacker, and the CCNA Cyber Op exams, all of them about security. There's a lot of overlap in these topics. A lot of the content is the same, a lot of the questions are going to be similar. So if you've been through some of these, you might find that the CISA Plus exam is a bit easier, right, than most people are going to find it. Does that mean that some of these are redundant as certifications? Well, perhaps. But in my opinion, it's a good thing because it helps you really refresh that information in your brain and store it on the long term. And one more thing, if you Google search for CompTIA CySA Plus exam questions, you will probably find some results, some PDFs, some forums, and you're probably thinking now, he's going to tell us not to search for those because it's not ethical. And yes, I'm going to tell you it's not ethical, but here's a better reason. First, the answers to those questions are painfully wrong and mislead you. And secondly, they give you a very bad sense of security, because very often you will realize that the exam has nothing to do with these questions that you found online. And that's a very bad thing to realize on the first 5 minutes of the exam. All right, so enough beating around the bush. Let's get down to business and jump into the first topic of the first domain for the CISA Plus certification exam. And don't forget to subscribe if you want to do a good deed for today and you want to encourage free IT certification training.